Welcome to the EPG Pathshala. Myself Supriyo Chanda, head of the Department of Museology, University of Calcutta. Today we shall discuss on museum publications. That is a module of the paper Museology of the subject Indian Culture. Museum publications constitute a very important component of museum functioning. Today our aim is to study what is museum publication, different types of museum publications, functions of museum publications, importance of the museum publications, challenges before the museum publications, and the probable way out to combat the challenges. Let us first start with what the museum publication is. This is one of the fundamental aspects of museum education programs. Museum publications must not only in case extend beyond the direct responsibility of making the museum's collections intelligently assessed or reviewed. Every notable museum has its publications that are made available to the public at a no-profit basis, obviously, because museums are non-profit making organizations. In every major museum all over the world, a special section is provided near the main entrance of the museum building called museum publication counter, sales counter, rather sales counter. Generally, publications of a museum are brought out by the education department, which are attached to every museum. Nowadays, sometimes they are also called the publication unit. This is always kept under the charge of a publication officer. In some museums, especially in India, there is no publication officer. We call it as editor of the museum publications. Museum publications can be divided into four groups. Number one, popular publications. Number two, advanced publications. Number three, serialized publications. And number four, administrative publications. Besides that, some museums also publish illustrative and descriptive materials during holding important programs like traveling, exhibitions and other conferences and seminars. So we may deal with what are the popular publications, because those constitute the bulk of the publications of a museum. The poster is one of the most important publication that comes under a very common program in every museums, because you need people to come to the museum and you need to inform people about the program or the collection or about your museums or your on the activities, and poster is the good medium for that. Aim of a successful poster is to attract attention of the viewer instantaneously, done either by catchy one-liners or novelty of lettering and typography, or by dramatized illustration, or by sharp visual contrast. A poster must not be overburdened with words or visuals. Too much visuals or words mar the efficacy of a poster. Posters serve to attract immediate attention of a visitor, to evoke urge to visit the museum or the particular exhibition or program. Selecting typography, color, and visuals are extremely important for a good poster. Nowadays, digitally printed multicolored posters are very popular. Large posters on vinyl sheets are popular, as these are easy to install and can be removed very very quickly within a short notice. Poster must give the minimum essential information like the museum, exhibition or object, duration, timing, venue, etc. The next popular publication is picture cards. This is the most popular type of museum publication. Here, authentic pictures or reproduction of museums, more valuable items are provided. Visitors usually buy them as a kind of memento or souvenir of the visit to the museum. Usually, they are sent to far and near as gift, and sizes generally are about 12.5 centimeters into 7.5 centimeters, that is the size of a postcard. These are mainly usually available in sets of 6, 10 or 12 cards in a very low price. Almost all the major museums in the world produce several such sets on the different categories of collections. Earlier, these were called picture postcards, as the visitors from places outside the location of the museum used to send these by post. On the reverse, the half of the space were kept blank for scribing few words for the senders, and the other half were reserved for the postal stamps and the address of the recipients. But with the wane of the postal systems, mostly these are not continued anymore. The cards nowadays are mostly use the reverse space for giving the detailed identification and object of the object displayed on the other side. Many museums have sets of such cards bound or stapled together in duplicate with perforations in the middle, so to retain a copy of the copy as memento for themselves. These cards are priced very cheap, within the common visitors' affordability, on no profit, no loss basis. The next popular publication has been the art albums. Some museums bring out art albums, either of works of different renowned artists or famous artworks. Quality prints of few selective or representative works of art are published in a cover along with introductory write-ups by the scholars. Prices are usually higher than the picture cards, that is obvious. The Indian Museum Kolkata, the National Museum New Delhi and the National Gallery of Modern Art New Delhi have several such sets. Art museums like the National Gallery of Modern Arts, New Delhi, also produce quality reproductions of the works of famous artists on good quality of papers. The folders are very cheaper variety of museum publications distributed to the interested visitors, usually free of charge, though currently some museums started charging minimum prices for the folders. This is an usual practice in abroad, especially in the UK, to donate a token amount to have the folders. Otherwise, the visitors are requested to return back the folder while going out of the museum. As the name suggests, folders can be folded and can be taken away. This can be one fold, two fold, and three fold. Generally, three fold folders are mainly used. The pictures also illustrate the same. A folder can be devoted to the whole museum or individual galleries or a temporary exhibition. This should provide all relevant information at a glance on the museum or gallery or the exhibition. It is a general practice to include a layout and a gist of other attractions, that means the other exhibits, important exhibits, extramural activities the museum deals with, and the general information like the accessibility, the bus routes, the ways, the maps, etc. The museums usually publish pamphlet or booklets. These are almost synonymous. These are often priced and are more elaborate than a folder. Published to give idea on a topic of exhibition or a group of exhibits in a very lucid manner. Science museum centers in India especially, they frequently use such publications to drive in the principles behind the concept-based exhibitions which they mostly deals in. Leaflet is, as the name suggests, it's a very cheap publication, mode of publication, the single pages, often used as publicity material and press handouts. The Birla Industrial and Technological Museum in Kolkata, while it was being inaugurated long back in 1959, they managed to distribute such leaflets through the bicycle reader employees to different congregational places like the bus stands, the marketplaces, the rail stations, and even into the alleys. Then another very elaborate type of popular publication is the guidebook. In the large museums, the guidebooks are published into different categories. One is the general account of the museum or collections, and the other one, the description of the single gallery, is given. All standard guidebooks include an account of more important materials accompanied by few pictures. The guidebook should be self-sufficient in its content. These are usually prized publications. Guidebooks generally provide a labeled ground plan of the museum showing exact location of different objects in the museum. The multi-storied museum include isometric plans of each floor separately. Additional information like visitor amenities, opening and closing times, schedule of guide services, etc. are also given. The photographs include three types of information: more important type of objects, general view of the gallery or galleries, the entrance of the museum or the museum building itself. Some of the museums, especially for the children, who have collection for the children, sometimes published game sheets which are often called as activity sheets. Different types of game and activity sheets are designed by different museums in the world. Some may have printed half-drawn sketches of any exhibit or object that are to be completed by the child. This kind of activity sheets were available in the Victoria Memorial Hall, Kolkata, and the Motilal Nehru Children's Museum in Lucknow. Coloring blank sketches are very common activity sheets. some museums also publish board games using the displayed objects. Interactive activities sheets are interactive activity sheets are used for participatory games like treasure hunt to find out particular objects in the museum and exhibition. These are highly effective to induce the curiosity among the children and also develop the cognition. Next comes the next type of publication, which are advanced publication. The name implies these are designed for the advanced type of the museum visitors, though those are more serious than the casual visitors. The most important advanced publication is the catalog. Catalog detailed information on the collections of the museums on the display or in storage. Catalogs may be of general or classified types. It contains photographs of the object. Very competent museum professionals actually compile information of the catalog after thorough research. Care must be taken to avoid controversial or doubtful views in the catalogs. Catalogs are generally priced not very high, but of course not for all the visitors. Catalog serves the requirement of scholars, researchers, and curious visitors for satisfying their academic urges. The next comes the monograph. As the name suggests, monographs deals with single subjects. These are usually brought out in the form of books. Monographs may deal with the collections of the museums or a particular program, a seminar, a conference proceeding, or a symposium, or even a topic of concern in the museum or anything that comes under the ambit of a singular objective. Monographs have limited circulation, meant for a specific target group and generally priced. The next group of publications are the serialized publications. As the name suggests, the serialized publications appear at regular intervals and have limited circulation, meant for specific target groups. Newsletters are such a serialized publication which keeps important information like new acquisition, upcoming programs, new appointments, visit by dignitaries, and related miscellaneous information. Very limited circulations are there for newsletter sent regularly to a list of people considered important to the museums are in the mailing list of the museum. And bulletins contain in brief the relevant information regarding the programs, acquisition, future plans, developments, etc., and mailed to the intended persons. It is more elaborate than the newsletters. These are generally thin and can be easily mailed at a reasonable cost. Next comes the journals. which are a result of various active serious academic pursuits. Articles of high standards are published in museum journals. Results of research conducted in the museum or outside with the help of museum collections are published in the journal. Subjects may be linked directly or indirectly to the museum collections or any frontier of knowledge. These are aimed to the scholastic audiences only. And the last category of publication is the administrative publications, which are in fact the museums are bound to publish at a regular interval to satisfy the legislative requirements, like the statute, which is a legal document defining the organization or the museum. This may include memorandum of association, rules and regulations, bylaws, etc. The mission statement is a written document of the museum and its purposes, policy, scope, and limitations. The forward plan, often called as management plan, actually gives an idea of the museum's future development plan for a certain period of time. It is sometimes also called strategic plan and also sometimes called that vision statement. Next comes the annual report. As the name suggests, it is published annually. There are the accounts of achievements, activities, number of visitors, financial statements, etc. of a museum during the just preceding financial year. This is the testimonial of the development of a museum. As the name suggests, this is published annually. Publication of annual report is a statutory obligation of a museum and is necessary for several administrative and financial procedures. Then the activity report, this is needed for garnering sponsor and more financial resources and the support for development activities. It gives relevant information other than the statutory facts needed to be given in the annual report. Activity reports are targeted to underline specialized competence at the museum's disposal. Importance of museum publication. The museum publications are very important because they are effective educational tools. It helps educating the visitors. Publication means a good resource for marketing. It is a good publicity material. The publication satisfied visitors' curiosity and their thirst for knowledge. Publication invokes interest for the repeat visit. It helps in getting feedback. It augments earning and helps in resource mobilization, especially in the museums in abroad. They do not depend on the gate money, rather they earn a lot of resources through the museum publication. And of course, it fulfills the statutory obligation. And there are certain challenges before the museum publications. In the because of that resulted because of the ICT revolution. This is probably the most difficult challenge. The internet, iPad, smartphone made information management and communication instant, handy, and highly flexible. That made the publication more redundant. The young generation has an unprecedented attachment to information and communication technology. This is, of course, a global phenomenon. We may quickly go through some of the figures. Presently, we have more than 4 billion users of YouTube per day. We have 2 billion active monthly users on Facebook. There are 328 million active monthly users on Twitter accounts. 600 million active monthly users for Instagram, and 1.2 billion people actively use WhatsApp regularly, monthly. All these pose a lot of challenges before the museum publication. In Indian perspective, we have 24.52 million telephone mainline users, that is 19.3 per thousand people, while the cell phone users are 1102.92 million, that is 86.84 per thousand people, and 218.42 million people use internet, that is the internet users per thousand people is 171.98. All the above developments have direct bearings with the museum publication. Even published texts are getting replaced by e-texts. Barring statutory obligation, most of the museum publications are facing the brunt. So what could be done? We must remember that despite technological advancement, multimedia could not replace publication. For the serious museum visitors, museum publication are sources of primary information. Museums cannot shirk off responsibilities towards such visitors. Museum publication must embrace multimedia and become complementary to the technological applications. Popular publications should be published in e-format along with the traditional ways. And to summarize the things, may say that publications are an important part of museum educational activities. Popular, advanced, serialized, and statutory publications are the types of museum publications for different categories of visitors or authorities. Publications are important for education, public relations, marketing, and resource mobilization. Internet and social media pose challenges before museum publication. Nevertheless, with innovative planning, museum publications are very useful. With these few words, we can wind up our discussion on museum publication. If more information are needed, please consult the e-text, and the questionnaires and the materials for the further studies are given in other modules. Thank you.